गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, आई एम सो हैप्पी टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। माई नेम इज़ आनंद कुमार एंड आई एम हियर टू गिव यू प्रोजेक्ट प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन सोल्यूशंस फॉर द बिगिनर सॉफ्टवेयर एप्लीकेशन डेवलपर। माई प्रोजेक्ट आई डी इज 2016 CSE PID 30 एंड वी हैव टू मेम्बर, माई सेल्फ एंड माई सेकेंड मेम्बर इज अभिषेक कुमार। वी हैव डन दिस प्रोजेक्ट अंडर द सुपरविजन ऑफ मिसेस प्रियंका गुप्ता मैम। She is the assistant professor of ABS Institute of Technology, Ghaziabad. Why we choose this project? Being a software developer, it is not easy to develop effective, faster and secure application when we have not complex knowledge as compared to the industrial software developer. Now these days, beginner software developer does not have the knowledge of how to create an effective web application, get template of the web application, find data breach, debugging the code, reduce from the load balancing, create a search engine and retrieving, processing and visualization of a web application. These all knowledge you can get in the industry but not in the college and online courses. Now these days the company hires the freshers from the college who has much knowledge about the above things, so that he cannot take much time for training and the fresher start working on the real project in very less time. According to India Today News, 80% of the engineer are unemployed in India due to improper knowledge between what he learned from the college or university and knowledge which is applied in the company. This generates the unemployment in the engineering student across India. This improper knowledge prevents a beginner software developer to develop a faster, effective and secure application. We aim to build an application that will be capable to determine public information, because retrieving unpublic data is illegal from any website. When we take the template from the website, that helps to create an effective, faster and secure website for the learning student, and it is used to determine which page are mostly highly connected and then visualize the page rank and connectivity of our small concern of the web and get your own data back out of the some system that has no export capability. We can monitor a site for new information. When we monitor on a site, then we prevent that website from data breach and load balancing and easily debugging our website. We can spider the web to make a database for a search engine. Technology used in these applications: we are using Python 3, URLib and BeautifulSoup to the retrieving information from the website and store that information into the SQLite databases and visualize result on the any browser using d3.js and force.js. Python 3. Python is the one of the most popular programming language, and every day people use to cool things like automation, and it is used in artificial intelligence applications, websites. If you looking for a job, Python is for you. Where is the package? This package contains 5 modules. First is request, second is response, third is error, fourth is pass, and fifth is robot parser. What is request? It is used to open URL. Request is used to open URL, and response is used internally by the request module. You will not work with this directly. And third is error. The error modules contain several classes for use by the request module. And the parser has a variety of functions for breaking up a URL into the meaningful pieces like the scheme, host, port and query string data. Robot parser is used to inspect the robot.txt file, what permission is granted to bots and the crawler. What is BeautifulSoup? BeautifulSoup is a Python library for getting data out of HTML, XML and other markup language. So you have found some web pages that display data relevant to your research, such as date or address information, but that do not provide any way of downloading the data directly. BeautifulSoft helps you pull particular content from a web page, remove the HTML markup, and save the information. The BeautifulSoup documentation will give you a sense of variety of things that the BeautifulSoup library will help with, from the isolating titles and the links to extracting all of the text from the HTML tag to alternate the HTML within the document you have working with. In the proposed methodology, this is the complete structure of the application. Webcrawler.py is a Python code that provides the web crawling. This retrieves the information from the web and stores into the crawler.sqlite database. Web crawling will help the beginner software application developer to easily learn the code because it gives the template of the web in very less time. We can monitor to our own website to prevent from the data breach, reduce load balancing, and easily used in debugging the code. It also helps to find which page is pointing to which page, or the number of incoming and outgoing links of the page. With the help of this, we create the page rank of the website. It will also help in the work resume for the new developer when the old developer leaves the company. This is the pagerank.py program, and that gives the page rank of the web. We can derive page rank by using the number of incoming links and outgoing links on a page. This can be derived with the help of probability. The page ranks form the probability distribution over the web pages. So the sum of all the web pages page ranks will be 1. We can run this program many times and it will simplify, refine the page rank each time. A search engine usually runs both the crawling and the ranking program all the time. And this is the rankreset.py program. It will reset the value of pagerank.py in the initial form. And this is the webdump.py. It is also a Python code. This shows the page that have at least one incoming link. When we run this code, this show the number of incoming links, the old page rank, the new page rank, the ID of the page, and the URL of the page. This is the webjson.py. It is also a Python code that visualizes the result on any browser with the help of force.js and d3.js. When we open the force.html file, then it will visualize the result on any browser. This is the this node is represented the page, and this age is represented as the number of link which is incoming and outgoing far from that page. Let's we execute the webcrawling.py program. This program is used to crawl the website and store that information into the SQLite database. We are importing SQLite 3 database and we are also importing URL package, and error is the module of URL package. Error, it contains several classes which is used by the request module. Request module also is the part of the URL lib. Request module is used to open the URL, and this is the parse module. Parse module breaks the URL link into the multiple pieces such as scheme, host, and data string. And this is the BeautifulSoft. BeautifulSoft is used to retrieve the information from the markup language such as HTML, XML, and this is the file name where the data is stored, which is retrieved from any website, and we are connect with this file with the help of connect method, and after connection we will connect with the cursor. After connecting with the cursor, it will execute the SQL command. We are creating three tables. First table is pages table, and second table is links, and third table is webs. And in pages table we are retrieving the information URL and text, errors, old rank and new rank. We are initialize the value of initially new rank equal to 1 and old rank value equal to none, because we are taking it in real form. That's why initially its value is null. We are taking the error as an integer value. And in the links table we have retrieved only two value, from id and to id. And after we have webs, how many website we are creating, that's URL of that website. These three table is created when these table are not exist. If the table are exist, then it not create any table. Let's we run this program using CMD. This is the Python code. First we write the Python, python, Python web crawling, web crawling dot py. This is the name of the Python code, Python program. When we will hit enter, it is asking which website are you want to crawl, then enter that URL of that website. Let's we crawl this website. This is the Coursera. We choose this website because I learned many programming language from this website. That's why I am choosing this website. First we will copy this URL and paste it here and enter hit. It is asking how many pages you want to retrieve from this website, from Coursera. We want to retrieve two pages, and enter two and hit enter. It gives the one page that has 650,626 character. In this page, this has character, and this is the link in this page. It has 102 link in this page, and second links has 410,842 character. This page has character, and it has 85 links. It also ask how many pages you want to retrieve. I don't want to retrieve more pages. First we will see the retrieve information is in the SQLite crawler file or not. We will hit enter. Let's open the SQLite database. Here is the SQLite database, and we can open the database where the file is stored. Open, and here is the file is stored, crawler.sqlite. We will open it on the database, and this it has three table: links table, page table and webs table. We can browse data from here, and here is the page table, and this is the id, url, html, error, and this is the HTML code of this page, web page. What type of language it is using, how we can build such type of pages, you can get the overview from here, and you can learn that language which is used in this web pages, so that you can create this type of web pages, a website. We can retrieve many information from that website, but here we are retrieving only public data. Retrieving unpublic data is illegal. We are this is the URL column. If any pages has any error, then it will show here and we will remove that error. Let's we go another table, that is links table. This is the ID of each links. From ID 1 we go from link 1 we go to link 2, page 2, and from page 1 we can go to page 3. This is the link from ID and to ID. Links table has only two columns, from ID and to ID. With the help of this we can create the page rank. And another table is webs table, which pages I want to retrieve, get information. This is the page name. Here is the Coursera website. We retrieve the information from Coursera website. You can get more information from your own website. Here we are retrieving less information because retrieving unpublic data is illegal. If you are own website, then you can retrieve many information. And when you monitor your own website, then you can reduce data breach, load balancing, and you can easily debug your code. And any developer left the company, then when the new developer came, it will help in work resume. Here we retrieved 10 more pages, and it is again asking how many pages you want to retrieve. And each page has different character and different link. This page has 14,21,486 character and 297 links. We are not retrieving more pages. Then we will hit enter. The dump information which is stored in the SQLite database here. Dump information. For dump information, we will retrieve the dump information. The page which has at least one incoming links. Let's see the program. And we are importing SQLite 3 database, and we are again connecting with this file, crawler.sqlite file, and we are retrieving and information such as number of incoming links, old rank, new rank, and ID, URL from the pages. This is the whole code. This is the whole code. Let's rerun. And let's rerun. Here we write Python. P-Y-T-H-O-N. Python. Web dump dump dot py. We will hit enter. It will retrieve the 12 pages which has this page has 25 incoming links, and the old rank is none. Initially old rank is initialized with none, and new rank is initialized with one. This is the ID of that URL. Each links has unique ID. This is the unique ID of each links, and this is the link of every pages. And this program retrieve the pages which has at least one incoming links. Once we have some pages in the database, then we can derive the page rank of that website. Here we will type Python, P-Y-T-H-O-N, Python, P-A-G-E, page rank dot py. This program give the page rank of the website. We will hit enter. It is asking how many iteration you want. In each iteration, it redefine the page rank of each pages. We will hit only 3 iteration I want. Here is the result. Each time it will give the new page rank of each pages. First the page rank is 0.88, and second iteration the page rank becomes 2.7, third iteration the page rank become 0.10. Then retrieve the dump information, and when we will hit enter, and this is this is the output of this program. Here is the number of incoming links, and the new rank become the old rank, and the new rank modify its value each time, each iteration it's modify its value. If you want to reset your page rank without spidering another website, then we will run. Let's we see the value. To see the value, we will run the webdump.py program. We will hit enter. Here is the old rank become 0 and new rank become 1.0. This program will get the initial value of the page rank. Here we again run the page rank, and the 10 iteration I do the 10 iteration. And if you want to visualize the result of the stored data in the database, then we will go in this program. Here is the program of visualization of the database, and here is the code of rank reset. Initial rank value we will set new rank 1.0 and old rank 1.0.0, and this is the rank reset program, and this is the page rank program. Here is the page rank program, and here is the WebJSON program connecting with SQLite database, and we are connecting with file crawler.sqlite so that we can retrieve the data from this file. And when we connect with the cursor, then we can run the SQL command. Here is the SQL command we are using. Let's we run the webjson.py program. Python 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 web json.py. After we will hit enter. It is asking how many nodes you want to show in the visualization of the data. We want 10 nodes. We will hit enter. It is telling that open force.html in your browser to view the visualization. We will open force.html, f-o-r-c-e, force.html. We will hit enter. This is the visualization of our data which is stored in the database. This is the link, this is the node, and each node had links. The nodes represent the page of the website, and these are the links, incoming and outgoing links. When we hover the mouse here, then it will show the links, and each node has unique links. This visualization is done with the help of force.js. This force.js and d3 2b.js. these two program is help to visualize the result. When we run webjson.py program, it will store the value in the spider.js. with the help of these two program, we will visualize the beautiful picture that is here. You can visualize in any browser. We can build our own search engine. Search engine run both the program simultaneously, pagerank.py and webcrawling.py program. We are hiding more information because we are crawling on another website. If you build your own website with the help of template, then you can monitor your own website, and on the basis of your requirement you will perform some changes in this program, and you can monitor on the based of your requirement. Our research paper publication details. This is the certificate of publication.
This paper has been published by the Journal of Xi'an University of Architecture and Technology. Our research paper entitled is Solution for the Beginner Software Application Developer, myself Anand Kumar from ABS Institute of Technology, Ghaziabad. This paper has been published in the JSAT Journal, Volume 12, Issues 4, and this paper has been published April 2020. This is my another group member, Abhishek Kumar. He is also get the certificate of publication from the Journal of Xi'an University of Architecture and Technology. We have done this project under the supervision of Mrs. Priyanka Gupta ma'am. She is the assistant professor of ABS Institute of Technology, Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh. And this is the link where our research paper is has been published. If you want to see the research paper, then you can see using this link. Thank you very much.